Hello students, welcome again. Today we are starting our grammar session. First of all, in this session we are going to learn about tenses. Maybe you are all aware of tenses, but here once again we will learn the tenses. Why is it necessary to learn the tenses for all the standard? Because in English tenses are very important in establishing effective communication. Hence, if you want to maintain the communication better from both the sides, means speaking and writing, you must know the tenses very well. Each tenses indicates the connection between two or more time period and exact present time in which activity occurred. Tenses can be used to create different meaning from the same word. Tenses can be used to create different meaning from the same word and also help to anchor that listener understand the meaning behind the story. Also, tenses we use to communicate about the event and location at that time. There are different tenses and they were identified by the associated verb form. It means while learning tenses we have to keep better attention toward the verb forms. Okay, so as you know there are three main types of tenses, that is past, present and future. Also in English each of these tenses can take other main four aspects like simple present, simple past and simple future. Also they have another aspect, that is continuous, again perfect, and fourth one is perfect continuous. So today students, we are going to learn first tense, and that is simple present tense. Okay, so let's start to learn simple present tense. Look at this simple present tense. What is simple present tense? What is the definition? If we are trying to do the definition is the simple present tense is used to express a habitual action or a general truth. Here students, what is simple present tense? It is used to express your habitual actions or anybody's habitual action or any general truth. In simple present tense we mention it. Okay, like that. Here I have given you example. Look at that example. Sachin plays cricket. While learning simple present tense we have to use many rules. We have to look at that properly. Look at that. If in a sentence with singular nouns and pronouns we added s or es or ies to the root forms of the verbs to identicate the simple present tense. Means suppose if anybody doesn't know about that how to identify the simple present tense, then they will recognize the tense with the help of this rule. Means what? What is that rule? Look at that rule or that formula again. If singular noun you can see in these following examples also, singular noun or pronoun is there, then there must be the s, es or ies to the root form. Means look at this singular noun form, Raju is there. Then we will read the whole the sentence, Raju reads very slowly. In this sentence, Raju is a singular noun and therefore we added the s suffix to the given root form of the verb. Again look at that second example, he goes to school. Here instead of singular pronoun, here he has come comes as a pronoun, singular noun instead of singular noun. Here he comes, it means here pronoun is there. Therefore we have added es to the given root form of the verb, and it will become like goes. He goes to school. Again, look at that third example. Sita studies very well. Here again, singular noun is there, and therefore we added es or ies to the given root form of the verb. So one can identify easily the simple present tense by looking at the form of the verb. If verb has s, es or es joined to the root form, then it indicates that it may be simple present tense. Here students, another different rules are there to identify a simple present tense. Just look at them. With I, suppose singular noun or pronoun is not there and the subject is I or you is there. I or you is there, or it may be a plural noun and pronoun is there, then we use the root form of the verb to indicate the simple present tense. Before, we have learned that if there is a singular noun and pronoun, we have to add s, es or ies to the given root form of the verb. But here, if the subject is I, you and plural noun or pronoun, then you should use the only root form of the verb. Like look at that example. I read books of general knowledge. Look at that example. Here subject is I, therefore I haven't added that reads. I only mentioned read. I read the books of general knowledge, because read is the verb. So you have to check it out, what is the root form, is there root form or any other changes in a verb. Okay, again look at that. Here they call the police. Here again plural noun is there. They then we use only call, not calls. So if there is a I, you or any plural noun or pronoun, then we will use only root form of the verb in a simple present tense. Here look at student, that third example. Teachers ask many questions. Teachers, here plural noun is there, and therefore use only root word ask, not asks. Okay, so teachers ask as many question is the correct sentence of a simple present tense. Student, let's see what are the other things keep in mind. Well, I am going to tell you some other important things about simple present tense. Okay, let's see. The following are the ways to form the simple present tense form of verbs. Means you can form the verbs by the following ways in simple present tense. Look at that. You can form the verb by adding only s, by adding only s to the verb. Look at that. Add s to most verbs when used with a singular nouns and pronouns of the third person. Look at that. If there is a singular noun or pronoun of a third person, then you should add s to the given verb. Like that example, Ramesh swims, because singular noun is there, Ramesh swims. And if we use pronoun instead of singular noun, it will also become he swims. Then if the subjects are he, she or it is there, then it you should add it s. You should add it s to it. Okay, then look at that next example. Add s, we have seen it, add es now to verbs ending in S C H S H X O R Z. If the verb has ended with S C H or S H or X or O or Z, then you should add ES to the given verb in a simple present tense. Like, look at that. Catch became catches, go became goes, and wash became washes. And it is also according to the given subject. According to the given subject, you have to add this. Okay, again, look at that next one. If the verb ends in Y, if the verb ends in Y, change the Y to I and add ES. Means you should have to change that Y into I and also add ES to it. Look at that example. Marry became marries. Marry became marries. Carry became carries. Do you understand what I'm saying? Carry became carries. It means carry, that Y changes to I and we added ES to it. It is here also, you should keep do attention to the given subject. Okay, student, let's see. Here, I have given you some sentence. You have to replace with the given subjects and make the changes in verb if it is necessary. Once again, I repeat. Here, student, I have given you some sentences for writing in your notebook. In bracket, I have given different subjects. Look at them. You have to use it in sentence, in a given sentence, and make the changes in a particular verbs in that sentence. Hope you understood well, and we will end here our session. Okay, students, thank you for hearing. Thank you so much. In next session, we will learn about next tenses.